So even though it seems this arc is ending in a really good way, a lot of you guys have felt the need to comment that it's not over yet, which makes me a little curious about what could happen. What's up, Dapper Squad? It's your boy Darius back at it again with Black Clover, episode 62. First and foremost, I just want to apologize if I sound a little funny or if I take a little bit to get into the episode. I just woke up and my throat is killing me, but you guys know the show must go on, so gotta keep watching animes, can't stop doing that. Last episode, we had Mars and Fana finally have some sort of reconciliation. The third eye on Fauna's head completely like withered away after finally remembering Mars in that whole flashback. It was a beautiful scene at the end of just utmost love and compassion. Everyone's feeling it. But like most shonen anime, when it ends on a high note like that, something's still going to go happen. Something's going to go down. So I say, let's find out what happens in this episode. Remember, if you guys want early access and full length to this show and all the other shows I'm watching, like Jujutsu Kaisen, Haikyuu, many, many more to come in the future, check out that Patreon. Links are down below for you guys. We are 4 episodes ahead over there. If you guys want to support me and Patreon's not really your thing, if you guys could just leave a like and a nice comment, it really does help me with the YouTube algorithm. Don't forget to subscribe if you guys currently are not subscribed. Click that bell so you guys always know exactly when I post. And don't forget to follow me on all my social medias, Instagram, Twitch, and Twitter, at DapperDarius. Thank you, guys. Black Clover, episode 62. Those who boost each other up. Let's do this. Of course, my guy. That is a throwback right there. Ooh, look at that. Heck yeah. You know Asta, best friend. Yeah, let's have a conversation with Fana. I would love to have a full conversation. No. How come this always happens to Asta? He finally saves the day or something happens and everyone starts beating on him. You guys see me itching my eyes at all throughout any of these episodes? Throughout the rest of spring and summer, my allergies are rampant. My eyes are so itchy. Is this Morris? The one who was doing experiments on the Diamond Kingdom mages. So that's when Fonzel thought she was dead after Morris's experiments. I would have to assume that that's Morris. I'm so curious. Yep. So Licht like implanted that magic or that third eye in there. So he took over her body. Would she know that at all? She has like no memories of when she was with them, so I wonder, you know? Which I don't think they, as in they, the Black Bulls, knew that there was a magic stone here as well. Yeah, they only came here for Asta. Oh, Ladros. I knew that wouldn't be enough to take him out. I said this when he got taken out. Oh, this is gonna be interesting. Ooh, nice. Thank you, Asta. You can emit pure magic, he can cut pure magic. He's my friend. That's what friends do. Hell yeah.
Wakaru yo sono tsurasa.
They would have some sort of relatability. Yeah, as if Asta would ever join the hands of a deranged killer like you. Obviously, he's gonna refuse. We have our own singular vision we're gonna accomplish. Look at that slashing, though. Ooh. Damn, because he could just reabsorb it too. Even the redirect. Recycle. This is actually difficult. Ooh, are we gonna get a backstory? No? The users and the use. A lot of people do think like that. Damn, Asta is not having any of this. As Naruto once said, why don't you give up on trying to make me give up? Maybe instead of right here, make it a little more center, just dead in his heart. But that was a great plan, Asta. Talk about me can't dealing with long range. Yeah, and then all the magic in you is seeping out. What, are you gonna pull that sword out? That is a embedded sword. That sucker is in there. It's gonna be the counter to Ladros's thing. I used other people to get to where I am. I couldn't have made it to where I am without the other people that have helped me, you know? We got Fonzel with the swords. We got Yami with the key. We got everyone who's constantly been there for us. A warrior never goes back on his word. Yep, Noel as well. Vanessa, Finral, Kahono, Kyoto, everybody. We've met so many people along the way that have helped us get to where we are right now. Couldn't have done it without them. My wife, Vanessa, my dude, Finral. Hell yeah. I'm glad they felt the need to show me that again. That shit looks so cool. Not my friends. Oh, the title of this episode. You love to see it. Oh, yeah. Good one, Ladros. Yeah. Don't do it. I know you're... That's smart Asta right there. So that's why he threw it there on purpose. I was wanting him to throw it right here. But no, it's Asta. He used it to launch himself in the air. So he got it out, which is good, but that probably hurt like hell. Two magic bullets left, and he's gonna go for Fana and Mars. The self-destruct magic is what he wants. Oh no. Cause what's his name? Morris? He was talking about the phoenix that lies within there. And then she was just talking about how she can't use any more magic. Does she actually have some sort of secret phoenix explosion? I think Ladros just burned to death. Hopefully. Hopefully you just see a pile of ash from where he stood.
Hmm. くいただきました。
てめえ！
おお。
聞いておっても早すぎてよくれなかった。
油断しない。遠距離から防ぎようのない攻撃を打ち続ける。
What's gonna happen? Somebody is Asta gonna have to? Is Asta gonna be able to do this? Is someone gonna save the day? Yami come out the queen? He's just been watching, eating popcorn this whole time. Is he gonna use that? He might be their descendant. What? What the fuck? Who's descendant? Show me who you really are. Who are you? I'm Darius. Who are you? So, I get super pissed at some shows. Like, Black Clover has definitely made me pissed before. Jujutsu Kaisen's probably the biggest. You know, Demon Slayer, Haikyuu. When it comes to these goddamn cliffhangers, how are you just gonna leave me hanging like that? Like, I cannot... I didn't even write anything down this episode, but... fantastic little... I don't want to say moral dilemma, because it wasn't a dilemma, but little thing they had to say throughout this episode. You know, there are some people there are a lot of people very much like Ladros, who are like, you're either the prey or you're the predator, you know, and that's the type of, you know, it's a dog eat dog world, it's what they say. But you know, I love how Asta said, you know, I definitely could not have been here without my friends, you know, and I don't think he would ever say this, but they wouldn't be here without him either. Like, that's what they would say, because they're also very humble and they realize as well. But that's what great friends do. It's not me use you, you go down here, I go up here. It's you boost me up, and then I get boosted up, and then you get boosted up. And that's what good friends do. They make each other better, competitive, you know, just constantly raising the bar for each other. And just making, you know, that's why Yuno and Asta are one of the best rivals and duos in all of anime. Confirmed. Like, yes, Naruto and Sasuke are like iconic, and a lot of people get pissed when I compare them to Naruto and Sasuke. Naruto was one of my favorite animes of all time, just because I grew up on it, you know, the nostalgia, everything like that. But it's so easy for me to admit that Sasuke is insanely, like, their relationship is toxic. It's not a good relationship. Whereas, is Yuno somewhat ballsy? Is he somewhat cocky? Yes. Do we love him for it? Yes. Yuno and Asta, but does he still stand up for Yuno every chance he gets? Will not let anybody talk trash? Will fight for him? Will... Yes, Yuno is the best. That is confirmed. But how is the queen gonna throw us with a randomly, he turned the tables. I thought you would be able to do it because you're one of their descendants. Like, first off, the queen is super old. That's been established. Second off, the queen is insanely strong. That's been established. Third off, what did she do with her fingers? Did she activate what was already innately in Asta, or did she put something in him to, like, kickstart a domino effect? Fifth off, seven off, whatever I just left off on, what descendants? How does she know that? And why does she not said anything before? I'm so curious. She was talking about how she wants Vanessa's thread magic and Asta's anti-magic. But that's not only with the queen. It also has something to do with the Eye of the Midnight Sun, because Licht also knows about the swords. So maybe, because she said, maybe I thought you'd be able to use it, because I don't fucking know. All I know is I want to watch this next episode. I think I'm about to, because this shit's about to go crazy. If you guys enjoyed, please leave a like. Let me know your thoughts down below. Check out that Patreon if you guys don't want to wait for the next bunch. You guys want early access, all that jazz. This is about to get crazy. Okay, I got it. All right, I'll catch you guys in this next one. Peace out, Dapper Squad.